So first we're going to go over the connections on the Mars Camtrak system.
First we have power, USB, which will be used for any type of firmware updates. You have HDMI and DisplayPort, which are used for external monitors. We have a LAN jack, which is connected to our network. TC-IN, which is time code in. This would be a reference to your production's time code. Today we are using two rovers, which are our actual trackers. These are connected using the supplied Vive Ethernet cables. And we're just using two of those today, but this unit supports three of them. And then we are running Genlock from a sync generator into our Vive Mars.
So to power your unit on, there's a power switch above your power connector. The unit will take a little bit to start up. So this is the main UI of your Mars. First you have time code, which if we had a time code supplier or what's called a tentacle system connected to this, you would see the time code of your cameras or production. You have Genlock, so this will display your frame rate of your Genlock sync. We have the rovers, which you can see rover one has a little icon next to it. That means that we have a lens encoder connected to it. We're using the low LED IndyMark Mark II. You can see that we just have two rovers connected. And then you have base stations. This will display how many base stations are on your stage and visible or active. Here's an overhead diagram showing how we have our base stations configured. We've set up three base stations that are mounted to the overhead diffusion frame. We also have multiple base stations floating around the set on stands. When props get in the way of a base station, we power that base station down using remote power, and then we recalibrate our system by doing a recenter on the Vive Mars. So first we're going to go into our network settings, and we're gonna go to Mars Network. So by default, the Mars is set up to obtain a IP address automatically that will use your router or whatever is handing out IP addresses on your network to determine the Vive system's IP address. Or if you need to do something manual and set your IP address, you can set your IP address here and then apply settings. You want to remember that this is the IP address of the Vive Mars, not of the machine that you're sending to. We're going to obtain the IP address automatically for our setup today. And hit apply. To power off or restart your Vive, you just hit the power and then power off, restart, or cancel. So before recentering your Vive Mars, you want to be very specific about how you set your root point, otherwise known as your zero point or your tracking origin. At the form stage, we measured from each side of the LED wall to determine the center of the stage, and then we measured the distance from the center of the LED wall outward 5 meters, and then labeled that using marking tape. So you can see here how we've set up our tape and aligned our tracker before recentering. So something also really to take into account is the Vive tracker's root point, or its zero point. This is where the actual origin of your tracking is going to be. So it's very important to keep track of this, do all of your measurements and calibration based on this point. Here's a diagram. You can see that the center of the Vive tracker is actually underneath the light at the bottom of the tracker. To set the zero point or the root of your tracking, you go to recenter and then select the tracker that you'd like to use to set your zero point. In this video, we decided not to go over the process of mapping the lens distortion. If you're doing any AR or virtual objects in your foreground or compositing, I would recommend going through this process, but we felt that This is covered in other videos and is not 100% necessary for in-camera VFX. If you've been following along with the in-camera VFX tutorials, you will have a base project already set up, which is what you're seeing here. But if not, I'm going to show you how to bring in your Vive Mars data and connect it to any source in Unreal Engine. So if you go to your Live Link window, mine is over here. If you need to find it, you can go to Window and then Virtual Production and Live Link. Go to Source and then Message Bus Source, and then you will see a Vive Live Link data here. Depending upon how many rovers you have connected, you should see them show up in your subjects. Okay, so you want to save your preset, save as preset, and then you're going to want to label this something like Vive Mars Live Link. To connect this to an actor in your scene, I'm going to connect this to our Frustum camera. You can either, if you're following along with the VP Toolkit plugin series, you can just go to tracking and then enable Live Link, select your subject. So this would be whichever rover is on your camera, and then select your Live Link preset. Now your camera should be live. I'm also going to go into project settings and go down to Live Link and select my Live Link preset from here, and make sure that you put your file path here as well, or it will not stick. And then we're just going to save. And then now your camera is connected to NDisplay. If you'd like to manually connect something to a tracker, I will add a little mesh here. I'll show you that real quick if you want to do that for your workflow. So here's a little Vive tracker. You just add a Live Link component. Live Link component controller. And then select your tracker. So now you can see if you move this around, it will update in real time. So now that you have the basic setup of tracking, we're going to move into doing the lens tracking offset. That's going to be the relationship between the tracker and the nodal point of your lens. For this, I highly recommend going through your lenses and finding the nodal point or the pivot point of your lens. There's a couple of YouTube videos online that you can use to find it, or in a pinch, you can just measure to the center of your lens. That's generally gonna get you a fairly accurate representation. Now with the Vive Mars system that we're using, if you go through the lens calibration distortion mapping, it will actually give you a correct nodal offset that you could just manually input into your tracking. So we're gonna go to tracking here. And then if we're going to manually offset our camera in relation to the tracker, we could add that here. So if I type in negative 12, that'll push the camera in relation to the tracker down by 12 centimeters. If I put in X, positive 12, it'll push the camera in relation to that tracker. If you're doing this manually, you want to measure from the tracker's zero point and then measure down to the lens and either a forward or right or left offset. And then you would enter that here. For this stage, we're going to use the VP Toolkit plugin to use a Vive Mars tracker to automatically set our offset from our tracking to our camera's pivot point. So we're going to use the Vive Mars system to automatically set the camera's offset in relation to the tracker position. This is really important to make sure that the pivot point of your virtual camera lines up with the pivot point of your camera and lens combination. And then enable the use tracker. You're going to want to select your tracker that you're going to use for your lens offset. Now this system is compatible with OptiTrack and Vicon as well, along with the original Vive series. It's just you have to understand where the zero point of your object is, your tracking object that you're using to do this. So once you enable that, you should actually see a little Vive tracker show up. No matter what tracking system you're using, that's just going to be the mesh. And then your calibration tracker will be represented as a little tracker here with a axis mesh connected to it. So first you want to measure the distance from the front of your lens to your nodal offset, or the front of your lens to the center of your lens if you want to just rough this in and get fairly close. In our scenario, we're going to actually add the Vive tracker offset from the Vive tracker zero point to where the Vive tracker is going to be connecting from the lens. So our nodal offset from the front of the lens to where the center of the lens is, or the nodal offset pivot point, is 11 centimeters. And what that does is it takes your tracker and it sets your camera back from it. So it's very important to know what that is or get it as accurately roughed in as possible. So once the tracker is there, you want to make sure that there's nothing in the way of both of your trackers so that they are getting correct data. And then just hit your set button. And you can see here that will automatically set the tracker relationship to the lens or pivot point of your virtual cinema camera or your frustum camera to accurately match the physical offset from your tracker to your camera and lens package's nodal offset. You can now see your offset here. So if you have to make any changes to that, you can manually do that through the widget. You can also do that just for note if you want to adjust this manually. You can actually go to your frustum camera and go to your camera component and then adjust the transform of your camera component. So you want to just make sure that visually that looks accurate as well. If you want more information on setting up your tracking in NDisplay with the VP Toolkit plugin, please see my other video where I go over setting the lens to tracker offset and calibrating your entire tracking system.